Here's my latest method for building Scenic Express super trees from start to finish. I'm going to start with the SuperTrees Super Value case. That's as big a case as you can get. They say it nets 300, 400 trees. I got 290 out of this box, so that's not bad. Here's what you get. It's a Scandinavian foliage of some sort, a natural plant that's dried. We're going to break it apart gently, eventually into individual trees. See how it comes apart. We take these smaller clusters and eventually get them down to individual scale trees. A nice big fat one there. Not worried about the curve at this point. We'll take care of that in a later step. A lot of curve in this natural plant material, but we'll show you an easy way to get that out of there. Here's one of the more tedious parts of the job. This material has these leaves on it which aren't really natural to what we're trying to make out of these things, in this case HO scale trees. They'll work for any scale though. Some are larger, some are smaller, and trees come in all shapes and sizes. So we've got to get in and remove all that leaf material, because that's just not going to look natural in the finished product. Now we go over to the stove and we're going to take care of that curve that most, if not all, of our individual trees seem to have. All the trees are going to benefit from a run through this little steam bath here. So, got a tea kettle on, open a spout, and I'm going to hold one end in my fingers, one end with tweezers, and gently pulling from end to end. I'm going to run it by the steam spout, then hold it with a little tension on it. About 8 seconds seems to be the magic number. And they're straight, and they stay straight. In my experience, for years so far. So here's a nasty curve at the top of this tree. The thinner trunk sections take less time as I work toward my fingers. At the thicker ends, I spend a little more time in the steam because that's a little thicker. But you can see it straighten out. Hold it again for the magic 8 seconds. And we've got another straight tree. Not looking for perfection here, but trees are generally straighter than this material comes out of the box. Doesn't have to be perfect, just fairly straight. I do leave a lot of trunk down at the bottom end. Some of this will be broken off eventually, but for right now it's just something to hold on to through the steaming and eventually the painting and staining process. So here's what I end up with, 290 trees, and they're sorted into three groups. This group I call the forest anchor group. These would be tall, thin trees that would look good at the front edge of a forest or the first three or four rows in. Good tall, thin trees that you'd see in Appalachia. The second group are probably the worst looking, but I call these forest fillers. They're going to fill in between the anchors to make the forest more full. The third group I just call the other, but they're some of the best looking trees. They have a larger spread. Some are pretty tiny, but these are trees that would generally look good on their own or in a small group of three or five. They'll stand on their own outside of the forest. With, as I said, about 290 trees completed to this point, I've got about 8.5 hours invested. So now we're going to move outside for the next steps. Here are the materials we'll be using. Some cheap light gray primer, spray paint. This is a mix of 70% isopropyl alcohol and India ink. It's 32 ounces of alcohol, 1 ounce of black India ink. Then Scotch Super 77 spray adhesive, also known as high tack adhesive. And there's the leaf flake material I'll talk about in a minute. And then finally, Super Duper Hold Aquanet Hairspray. Here's the leaf material. I get it from Scenic Express. They're at sceneryexpress.com. Same place you buy the Super Tree material. I'm modeling mid to late summer, so I'm choosing four different shades of green. I should have a primary shade I use for like 7 out of 10 trees, and then the other 30% a mix of the other three shades. If I were to ask you what color tree trunks are and you say brown, I'd tell you to look again. They're actually a light gray with some darker gray and black highlights. So we're going to spray our trees, trunks and branch structures is what we have so far. Even though that material kind of looks green and even some autumn color red in there, those are just the branch structures. They're not the foliage. So I'm going to paint all that with our cheapo light gray primer spray paint. They're going to look too gray. Too light gray at this point, but we'll fix that up in the next step with the stain. You do want to get the central tree trunk all the way up covered well. The rest of the branch structure it kind of mists with the light gray. You're never going to get it all covered completely. Don't worry about that. Through this whole outdoor process of painting, staining, and adding the foliage, really there's no significant dry time to worry about. I can move right to this next step after painting. I'm doing a batch of about 50 trees, so by the time I get through 50 in painting, it's plenty dry enough to move on to this. This is the staining with that India ink and alcohol solution. Just got it poured out into a little tub. Probably could have been a little bigger tub in hindsight, but just dipping it. It's going to look way too black, but after the alcohol evaporates away, it's going to make a nice looking tree trunk and branch structure color. Here they are, kind of laid out to air dry for just a few minutes before we move right on to the next step. Now with our spray adhesive, I'm going to spray the upper branch structure where I want the leaves and foliage to stick to, not the trunk down at my fingers. The tack time for this adhesive says between 15 seconds and 15 minutes. That means I'm going to wait a minimum of 15 seconds to apply the material and a max of 15 minutes. So I work through about 5 or 6 at a time, and I've dumped one of my foliage colors into a pan, and I just sprinkle it over the tree armature and get good coverage, tap off any excess, give it a little squeeze, and just drop it off on a tarp on the ground. I'll drop them individually so they don't touch each other while the tacky glue is still tacky. You do want to do each tree in a single color green, or a single shade of green. You don't want to mix shades within the same tree. Last step, hit it with a generous spray of the extra, extra, extra hold unscented hairspray. I'm showing you this as the last step. I actually don't do this until just before I'm ready to plant, because this stuff does tend to stay a little tacky. Here they are laid out, just waiting for that high-tech adhesive to dry. Then I'll stack them gently in a box. I'll break off some of the longer trunks before planting, but that gave me a good handle to hold on to. Total time invested for a total of 290 trees in the case, about 22 hours.